last week, we took you guys with us to Savannah, Georgia. We went on an adventure. We went to explore the city, but we never shared with you how we felt about Savannah. We kind of told you before we got there that we were feeling not super, super excited about visiting another city. We kind of let you in on the fact that we are not city people. You know, let's ask Carl first what he thinks, and then I'll tell you what Nene thinks. You know, everyone's just dying to know, what does Carl think about Savannah, Georgia?
Oh my gosh,
I enjoyed it. That did not feel like a city at all. With all the trees, it was laid back. It didn't feel like the hustle bustle and everything. So a lot of culture it seemed. People weren't like super on edge, everyone smiling, waving. So if people are happy, I'm happy.
Yes. Carl,
what?
I feel the same way. I thought Savannah was like super, super cute, cool city.
Oh my gosh, death.
Today's gonna be an intense day. A couple months back, we took you on a journey when we drove through I-10, and everyone was telling us like, oh, I-10 through Louisiana, Mississippi, it's horrible, it's gonna rattle your bones, and we were so nervous. We filmed the whole thing. You can check out that video. But today, we're going on a different interstate. The majority of the people said this was the scariest interstate to drive on. Some people left some really interesting comments that said, it'll shake you down to your kidneys, it'll rattle your teeth. So that's what we're gonna hit today, and I'm kinda nervous. Did you guess yet? That's okay, I'll just leave you in suspense and you're gonna see in a second which one I'm talking about. We gotta get out of here. We gotta hook up, he's waiting for me. He cannot do this without me. Look at, he's.
I guess I'll do all the work over here.
See, I guess I gotta do everything. Nene here, we have something awesome to share with you guys, but let's find Carl first.
Thanks, from the Hanks, Carl here. Look at you guys on the screen, y'all look amazing.
I love all your shirts and your photos you're sending us. We love it, love it. You guys are so awesome. With your help, we were able to raise over $800 for the Family Reach organization.
Yes.
So we just went ahead and rounded that up to $1,000.
Without you guys, this would not have been nearly as successful as it was. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts for helping us donate to this amazing organization.
Yeah, you guys rock, and we're gonna be coming out with more merchandise pretty soon, so stay tuned.
Keep your eyes peeled, but nonetheless, let's get back to this bumpy roads of a video.
Whoa.
We'll see you over there.
Trash, 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 trash,
trash, trash, trash, trash,
trash.
What kind of vibe do we want that song to be?
Trashy.
Hopefully there's not a line getting out of here, because I've been seeing a line of people. You know what? I'm wondering if you should go around.
I'm not going to take Raccoon Way. That just sounds way too trashy. Why does it seem like no matter how hot it gets, I'm still drinking hot coffee, though? I'm like drenched in sweat, but I'll drink hot coffee.
Because that's adulthood, baby. Cheers.
Cheers. I didn't forget the trash this time.
Uh-oh, here we go. You guys know what interstate it is yet? Do you know? It's gonna rattle our bones, apparently.
So many people said that 10 was child's play compared to 95, so we'll see, we'll see.
What are we thinking so far? We've been on it for a whole 10 seconds. What do we think?
It's fine so far. What was that?
I'm gonna think we're gonna be hard pressed to find worse roads in like Indiana.
Oh, a lot of people said Michigan had some rough roads too.
And it does. Oh. I'm just kidding, we just went over a bridge. What was that? I hear noises.
Bob!
Woo!
Okay, that wasn't that bad. We blew that up before our gym. Yeah, that.
I mean, look at all the pieces of tire on the road.
The memories, the remnants of people's travels. We hit some traffic and I just had an epiphany. The other side, the other lane over here to my left, man, it was so crazy. All of them all of a sudden just started hitting their brakes and it just like dun 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 dun. And what the problem is, how you fix that is you be proactive rather than reactive. See, everyone driving down this road is listening to the radio, talking on the phone, they're distracted. So they react to whatever the person in front of them is doing. So if everyone waits the last second to react to the lights in front of them, it's going to create that backup of traffic, and you multiply that times 30,000 people on the road, well then that creates a lot of traffic. So that's why you ever see those truckers that are driving down the road and they like have like 700-800 feet of lane in front of them?
Yeah.
Because they're trying to break that up. They're trying to break up that pattern. Because everyone behind them will kind of gradually just kind of keep on going in a smooth, steady pace. It's that constant, like slam, 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 and it just like backs up.
So pay attention, people on the road.
Yeah, drive like Carl would.
What would Carl do? Carl would be proactive. You're actually good at trying to like break that up when that happens, because you just take it really slow.
People get so mad. They're like, I gotta go 15 extra feet. And then they like get in front and then they're like, I feel so much better.
Everyone in the comments right now is like, he's aggressive.
Hashtag RVlife. It's funny because people think you can see the country in like a year or two. And it's like,
no.
After 5 years, we have not even touched the surface. So I went on the Google to actually research and look up what part of I-95 in South Carolina is the worst. Is it northbound? Is it southbound? Is it like a certain section, you know, like northern? And the best I could find is that traffic and weather up north is worse. Like Boston, Philadelphia, and I'm like, duh, that's because it's a major city. We're riding the bull today and we're gonna see how it goes.
Woo!
Dexter's gonna be in the back with like a little cowboy hat on with a little straw in his teeth, like, here we go, cowboy.
I don't reckon you've been on this road before, have you?
We need to go back to Texas.
You know what else really helps in traffic?
You actually got the speed limit!
Oh my gosh! The speed limit is 55 and we're going 46. So we're at risk for an accident.
They're swerving all over the road.
I see you. It's okay though. We're not in a rush.
Are you okay, Carl?
We're not in a rush. Holy mackerel, why would you park a tractor in the middle of a pond? Now that is some advertisement.
What are you doing, JCB?
Do those things have four-wheel drive, you just like plow through a pond? Look at the size of that bad boy. Now that's a flag. Let's get one of them for the back of the RV. That flag back there, how much do you think that bad boy weighs?
Like 10 pounds.
Google it. Google it right now. Can you Google it for me? I gotta know.
That specific flag? How would I know the dimensions
of
it?
Just Google, how much does a really big flag weigh?
Oh, okay. It's such a short drive day and Carl is already really getting on my nerves. You know, we weren't gonna have another cup of coffee today. And he usually calls me out on having lots of cups of coffee. And now he's just way too much. How much does a really large American flag weigh? 3,000 pounds.
No way, are you serious?
Well, that's the super flag.
Where's that at?
I knew it wasn't just gonna be a simple answer.
Doesn't that blow your mind though? That has to blow your mind.
It's in someone's yard. The flag is about 1.5 football fields long and almost entire football field wide.
What? That's huge.
Yeah, I don't think that's that flag.
So. Okay, hold on real quick. Remember Kennedy Space Center?
Yes.
Remember the flag on the side of
Yeah,
that's intriguing. Like, stuff like that intrigues me. How many gallons of paint did they use to paint that flag on there? Wasn't it like 900? No, it was like 3,000 gallons.
6,000 gallons of paint.
Oh, well, it must not be that important then if you remember the numbers.
I remember everything.
So you're just mocking me over there like you don't care. And then you're like, actually, it's 6,213 gallons of paint. Thank you very much.
I already Googled it and looked it up. And learned about it, did you? And now, are you gonna remember how much the largest flag weighs? Probably not.
We need a privacy screen right here, where I'm just like...
We're so done, and I hope we do not get a flat tire or anything crazy today. Knock on something. Is this wood? That's foot.
Why don't you knock on your head? That's enough air in there. It was a joke.
If we, like, this is just not a good day, and at least I brought snacks this time, because our last drive day that was supposed to only be 2 hours, we were hangry and not prepared. So, oh, no, stop, give me that,
woo,
give me that, no.
Oh, come on, it's just coffee.
No.
I feel great.
Your son's trying to sleep. You know, he is sound asleep back there because he is so used to all of this. Us yelling, the driving, the bouncing, he's like, music to my ears. He's like,
I feel so focused.
Now I'm not even afraid of I-95, I'm afraid of Carl. The reason we, oh! Okay, that one looked like it was gonna be rough. I was hanging on for dear life. We're okay though. It's not rattling my bones yet, but there are potholes.
Really? Because you're sure playing the part over there.
Just wait till Carl hits one that humbles him. We're heading to Myrtle Beach. We're on our way to Myrtle Beach, but we're stopping at a state park. A along I-95 for a couple days so we can get like the video caught up and everything. And the reason we're going to Myrtle Beach is because there's a Grand Design Rally happening there. So we're going to our second Grand Design Rally. It's not as big as the national grand one that happens in Indiana every year. So we're gonna see.
No, you're done.
Finally, getting our gray tank repaired. We're getting it replaced. We're going to Campers Inn the day before. Do you think they'll let us boondock in their parking lot the night before? Because that would be cool.
Did we check to see, make sure that they actually sent the part? Because I remember we were waiting to hear back if they actually mailed the part to this dealership.
I guess I'm gonna call them. I'm gonna put that on my to-do list. Don't you worry. I'm gonna call Campers Inn. It's been so long that we haven't had this gray tank replaced that I kind of forgot about it. No way.
It's like become like that piece of our family that just is there.
The broken piece of our family. So that's what's happening. That's what we're looking forward to. So you have to stick around to see. Will Campers Inn get the tank replaced in one day? Because we're not 100% sure if they will. And what are we gonna do in Myrtle Beach? We're gonna see our friends again.
Yeah, you're gonna go swimming with sharks again?
Yeah. I think we're gonna try stand-up paddle boarding, like surfing. We're gonna try that again, because I tried that once before and it didn't go well.
No.
There's a lot for you to stick around and look forward to, because you know how the Hanks are just bringing the crazy everywhere we go. Crazy Coffee Carl.
That's right. Coffee's starting to wear off. I need another cup.
Come on. No.
No.
Another
cup.
No.
Oh, here we go.
Oh.
Whoa. Okay. Whoa. Yep. We're starting to get to the juicy details.
Here we go. Whee. Ride the pool.
A lot of packs of snacks today. I'm hungry. Why are you looking at me like that? Oh! Oh, that!
Do bridges count? Like the little humps you do before and after bridges. Does that count as potholes? Comment below! With urgency!
Wow, look at the sign.
Oh, that sign hit a pothole right there.
That's what the RV is gonna look like after we're done driving on 95.
Oh boy, that's not a good sign. That, get it? That's not a good sign.
Honey, nice. Oh wow, that is awesome. Nice.
I'm having a hard time seeing the potholes from far away. So let me just, there we go. Oh, it's a whole new world. Oh boy.
Getting bumpy.
Wow. The road was so nice for a while, and then all of a sudden it just got a little crazy, so we had to pick it up. And we are currently on mile marker 38, South Carolina, I-95. Whoa! Hold on. Whoa. Oh, that's a big one. Oh. I'm acting like I have to hold on, but I just want you to see my big muscles. Just like a Disney ride, no big deal. You're, oh my gosh, you know it's coming when you see the car in front of you bouncing. We are on a back road on our way to Colton State Park. It is another state park that has full hookups. I-95 so far so good, do you think? Like, it's drivable, I think. But we'll be back on I-95 when we leave here, and then we head to Myrtle Beach. We got big things coming up.
Myrtle Beach is gonna be off the hook.
It's gonna be a great time because we get to see all of our friends and we get to like hang out with some peeps that probably haven't met us before, that they know we're coming, and we're gonna be by the beach. And supposedly they have a lazy river at the place we're going. Ooh, that sounds so nice. We're gonna be pulling into the state park. So if you guys are here and you know the Hanks are crazy, well, look out, we're coming for you.
Woo!
That's a warning. Seriously. It's a warning.
We'll back up. I'll have you back me up. Okay. And then we'll pull in right here, and then that's where you drop off, I believe.
Hey, sure.
No, I'm not. It's like nerve-wracking to watch them take it away, because it's like, well, first of all, hopefully everything goes smoothly. Second of all, I'm like, oh, those jacks are like completely extended and it's just like barely hanging in there.
Has the underbelly dropped and like ready to go?
Well, it has to be here, right?
9 minutes on hold. and I think they forgot about me. Things break and it has to go in for service and you don't really get any clear answers. It's really stressful.